What's up, guys? It's Brandon here from Bloody Breakdown, and we have got another big Blumhouse Halloween update for you all. Just dropped on Bloody Disgusting just this morning in an article that was written by Brad Miska, I believe. Hopefully I'm not mispronouncing his last name. And the reason I bring him up is because this story is pretty much just coming from him. He's saying that he's got a very reliable source that he feels is a trustworthy source, trustworthy enough to be able to put this out onto the website of BloodyDisgusting.com, which, as we all know as horror fans, is one of, if not the biggest horror-related websites on the internet. So, with that said, like I said, pretty big Halloween news here, and that is that not only is David Gordon Green returning to direct one more Halloween sequel, he is coming back to direct two Halloween sequels. Now, this isn't huge news, you would think, just on that alone, considering that last year, whenever Halloween came out and the months leading up to it, we had heard that the original plan was to film two Halloween sequels back to back to release them, you know, a year or two apart. This is where the big news drops and where it gets a touch crazy. They are not only planning, and once again, guys, I just want to reiterate, this is rumors at this point, but if you know, we're getting editorials from Bloody Disgusting that say they have enough confidence to be able to put this out into the atmosphere, then I take it with a little bit more than just a grain of salt. The big thing about this is that they are planning on filming them back to back, and not just filming them back to back, but releasing them back to back. And when you say that, automatically you think, okay, one in October 2020, another one in October of 2021. No, the idea behind this is to release the next installment of the Halloween franchise in October of 2020, and then release the very next installment in the Halloween franchise in the very same month of the very same year. And kind of going back to what I had said earlier, with Halloween 2018, we had all heard that they were going to film two Halloween movies back to back and kind of release them with a much bigger time span in between than just less than a month. But with the complications of the ending and how that had to be retweaked due to some audiences seeing test screening that and really not liking how that went, I think they kind of went into emergency mode and scurried to give us the film we have, which I have no issues with, to be honest with you. So if this is true, this is historic for the franchise of Halloween. This is historic for the genre of slasher horror. This is historic for film in general, because, and I'm sure I've got some film buffs out there. We talk about film on this channel, even though it is just one select genre. I can't think of any other time in history where a franchise has released two theatrical releases back to back so closely, especially with a franchise that is as big as Halloween. And, you know, speaking of big, $250+ million this movie made at the box office. I speak of Halloween 2018. So Blumhouse, it would not shock me if they put not all their eggs in this basket, but definitely a lot of them. And they have so many things coming up on the horizon that I really feel like Blumhouse is about to take off, as if they already haven't. But it's definitely very different. I think it's a pretty risky thing to do, especially considering some of the bigger mistakes in the Halloween franchise have come when they released things a little too quickly, when they jumped on the ball after Halloween 4 success and hit us with the cancer that was Tina in Halloween 5, among other cancerous things in that film. So, you know, you have to look at it like maybe it's, you know, with a little bit of standoffishness, like maybe this isn't a great idea. But then there's another side of me that says that, you know, if they can pull this off, if they can make two really interesting and entertaining and successful Halloween films and release them both in the same month, the month of Halloween, this will be the biggest month in the history, you know, of the franchise for fans. And for Blumhouse and everyone else involved if things go the way that I believe that they will, if this goes down. So one more time, just want to reiterate, this is rumors at this point. I'm going to put a link down below to the article from Brad over at Bloody Disgusting so you guys can read it yourselves. But yeah, I guess that's about all. Let me know what you guys think, because this is some pretty big out there fucking news, if I'm being perfectly honest. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Leave me a like if you enjoyed the video. Leave me a thumbs down if you think I'm a piece of shit and I don't need to make YouTube videos anymore. I don't care. It's whatever. Be honest. Also, guys, if you're new here, subscribe and ring that bell right next door to the subscription button. And if you click that bell, like I say, hopefully YouTube will let you know when I go live or upload. Also, down below that in the description section where I'm going to be placing the link to this article, you're also going to see some other links to follow us on social media or even support us. But to tell us more about that is a guy that thinks this idea is batshit fucking crazy. Or he loves it. I don't know. I can't fucking figure out where I stand on this right now. I will say I'm excited, but I'm vamping now because I couldn't think of anything to say to transition into what you're about to see. So just give me some money and I won't have to do this anymore.
If you enjoy my content and want to support Bloody Breakdown, here are a few ways you can do so. Become a patron of the channel at the Patreon link below. You can make a one-time or a monthly contribution. Simply select a tier of $1, $5, or $10 and unlock the perks that come with your tier of choice. Perks range from early access of videos to your name in the credits listed as a producer. Check out our Amazon wish list with tech items that could go a long way in improving the overall quality of the channel and the podcast. Install Honey. Honey is a free web browser extension that automatically finds and applies coupon codes at checkout for over 30,000 shopping sites, saving you money and coupon searching time. It only takes 2 clicks to install, and using my link in the description section below helps to support Bloody Breakdown.
Speaking of Patreon, we're about $7 away from hitting our first goal, where I'll be doing monthly Blu-ray reviews. New Blu-rays come out every month. I'll go pick one up and do a review on the film itself, on all the special features, on the packaging. So we're so close there on Patreon, so consider supporting. And yeah, once again, let me know what you think about this crazy ass Halloween news in the comments below. And until next time, I'm Bran from Bloody Breakdown, and we'll catch you then.